Bhagavad Gita, chapter 4, text 19. Yasisare samarambha kamya sankalpavaritaha jnanagni dagna karmanam tamahu panditam buddha. One is understood being full knowledge whose every endeavor is devoid of desire for sense enjoyment. He is said by the sages to be a worker whom the reactions of work have been burned up and by the fire of perfect knowledge. So when every action is based on the spiritual desire, not on the material desire. Material desire is bhoga, basically desire to have experience, to have material enjoyment. The problem is that it binds the consciousness by having the desires to experience the matter, enjoy the matter. It binds us to the law of karma, and that's how we become blind to see our real consciousness. But one who is in a full knowledge is someone who is whose every desire is a spiritual desire, which means that they are moving towards the spiritual direction and they are not bound by the action. And that the perfect understanding what is the meaning of the life, that's the one that is like a triggered the burning of the karma. In that sense, you can say that the bhakti yoga is jnana yoga because it's based on knowledge. We see if you see that like realigning with the supreme is the highest, like a highest state of the consciousness. If you have that understanding, and if you really internalize, which means that that's on the vijnanaya level, that understanding, then we start to act according to that understanding. So it's based on that sense, yoga is based on knowledge. Because in order to practice yoga, move towards the spiritual right direction, I have to know like what is best for me. Bhagavad Gita, ki chai.